Hotel family, coming back to you again. We're doing an oil change, and I'm doing something new. I'm having a cleaning my motor out for the first time. As usual, we're gonna start off by jacking up the front end of the car. Make sure you put bricks behind your tires, jack stands, and here is the stuff I'm using. This is gunk out, motor flush, get it at AutoZone, Kragen, whatever. And I just bought this Lucas heavy duty oil stabilizer. If you got heavy engine tick or whatever problems, you use that, it works real well. Mobile One full synthetic 10W30. My motor is 140,000 miles, so you use the 10W30. And also, I have the Mobile One oil filter. Show me what it looks like there. Before I got started, you gotta drain some of the oil fluid out. And then I can add the gunk out, motor flush. Add that full bottle. And once you add the full bottle, you want to run it. Run it for 5 minutes. Don't drive it. Just idle the car. Idle car for 5 minutes. And then you can flush your fluid out. Oil fluid out. And it's all watery. No, I got surprised when it was all water. I thought it was going to be like some regular motor oil fluid. And right here, I'm showing my brother the instructions because he didn't get it. And put your cap on. Make sure you put that cap on. You don't want to run it because all that oil comes out. Checking the dipstick, make sure it's at a safe level. You don't want it to be a little fluid in it. After you run it 5 minutes, we're going under here and taking the bolt off the oil pan. Get all that fluid out. And you notice if you've done the oil change yourself, it's supposed to be like kind of milky. This one comes out watery from the motor flush. Make sure you wipe off all the oil you get on your car. That stuff stays on there almost forever. It's really hard to take off. If you get it on my downpipe right there, you get it on your downpipe and your car heats up, you smell that burning oil smell. After you do that, get your little pan right there and get the oil filter. And then the oil filter is supposed to be hand tight, but they sell stuff at AutoZone Kragen for like get some of that from the filters off if it's too tight. But normally you just want it hand tight because you don't want it real tight. It's a pain when it's real tight, trust me. Mine's a turbo model, and I have to drain the oil drain line since mine's a turbo model, but I'm not going to show that here right now. I'm showing the standard procedure for it. After that, get your new one. I'm showing you the oil filter gasket right there. get some oil on your finger and just lube it up, lube the sides up, so you don't want it to crack on you when you tied it. You don't want it to leak out, have any oil leaking from it. And remember, it's supposed to be hand tight, just hand tight. You can have it tight, but you know, just tight enough so you know you can get it off. Heavy duty oil stabilizer. I'm using this for the first time, and it comes out like transmission fluid. It's really thick, so it took a while for it to get all out the bottle. But you want to use the whole bottle, just dump it all in there. It works very well. No ticking and no noise at all. It's real good. Here, I got the, you want to add the mobile one, motor oil. This one says 75,000, over 75,000, but I've been only used it for while my engine reached 100,000. You can do whatever you want. It's your car. Mine takes about 3 or 4 quarts, or 4 or 5 quarts, one of those. But if you got a V6, you're gonna need like what, 2 more bottles, 6 quarts? I don't know. I've been 4 cylinders pretty much all my life, so it's about 3, 4 or 5 quarts, 3 or 4. Once you get all them bottles up in there, top on, run it, see how you like it, dig in the scene with the gangsta lean. Keep y'all good for another, 5,000 miles? I forgot how long you're supposed to change. Did a transfer case, rear diff fluid before I did all this, so I was out there for a while. If you want to do a tune-up, this is one of the things you're gonna do. But I'm gonna have to do my spark plug wires and spark plugs. You know, that red wires. Those are my spark plug wires. Those are magnet cores. But that's another video. Thanks, O'Shea, for watching. Y'all stay blacktastic. All right, peace.